Morning and welcome to America's Home Cooking. I am going to make Franco's lemon chicken today. I'm going to show you, it's from Italy, this recipe. Now they want about 3.5 pounds of chicken. You can cut it up. I'm using chicken legs for this. And what they want us to do to add to this is 1/4 cup of lemon juice. They want 2 tablespoons of olive oil to add to this. This is a very, very nice recipe. Now they want you to add about 2 teaspoons of dried oregano. If you use a fresh oregano, it'll be a heaping tablespoon. And they want you to take a clove of garlic and mince it to put in here. I guess if you have a small clove, you'll have to use 2. I have 1 large one here, so I'm just going to use 1. But if you have small ones, please use 2. Oh. I would smash it with a big knife, but I'm only going to cut 1 clove, so I'll do it the other way. It doesn't make sense. Want us to add salt and pepper to this. That's a judgment call because they don't give you an exact amount when you use these cookbooks from other countries. They're sort of general on it. Going to do. I need a fork for this. Mix this up. You're going to pour it all over this chicken. And it's going to sit for a couple hours, and then we'll come back to it, but it's sitting. Periodically come back and turn it, and, you know, toss it around in the liquid to make sure they all get coated and get the flavors mingling together. Back when it's time to cook it. Okay, now we're going to turn the oven to 400. Make sure that it's in the middle of the oven, the shelf. Well, that's heating up. What we're going to do is you need a baking dish, and they want us to just lay the chicken in here. And that's what you're going to do. I had chicken legs, so I just used chicken legs. But they do recommend using a whole bird. And what you're going to do is you're going to take all of this and you're going to pour it over the chicken. When that oven gets to 400, we're going to be roasting it. So that's what we're waiting for now. And they want you to roast the chicken, they said, for 30 minutes. Then you're going to turn the pieces skin side up. Well, mine's on skin on both sides, so it doesn't matter. And continue to roast until brown and the juices run clear, which is going to be about another 45 minutes. Then after that, we're going to move the chicken to a platter and cover it loosely. We're going to pour the juices through a fine mesh, and that's going to be the gravy that, or the sauce that we're going to pour over the chicken. And that's going to be good. So, we're waiting for the oven, and I'll be back. Okay, it's at 400. Now we're going to cook these for 30 minutes.
minutes.
Okay, it's been 30 minutes. We're going to take them out and turn them over. Next time we put them in, it's going to be 45 minutes. Now the book reads to cook it for another 45 minutes or until the juices run clear from the bones, okay? So that's where we're at now at this point. We have to wait for it to cook. It's done. Okay, the chicken's done. Do is serve them. There's something that people bypass sometimes. It's very, very important that you make a presentation with your food. It brings up the appetite, as well as when they smell it cooking, they get hungry. When they see it and it's laid out nice, it's so inviting that they love to come and eat. It's not just that you cook it, but also that it's presented so they can enjoy it. That was one thing don't throw it around. That was something that we were taught from young, my generation. The presentation of the food is just as important as the preparation of it and everything else. So as you feed your family, if it's appealing to your eye, it will be appealing to their eye. That's why desserts are so easy. People dress their desserts up. When they make the main meal, they're not always so quick to do that. And that's when you should dress it as well. Okay? So, they want us to strain this, and we're going to pour this over this. So, we need a small strainer.
Get my little
ladle. A little ladle does wonders. Now what do I want to put it in? That's on the top, and what you want to do is skim off as much of this fat as you can. Because you only want the drippings. You're going to get some of the drippings, but you want to get most of the fat up if you can. It's not easy. Because there isn't that much. Mother always said, just lay it in very gently and the fat will come. Well, it worked for me. I can't see the fat coming in, but I'm taking some of the drippings too. But I'm getting more fat than the drippings. You won't be able to get it all unless you stick it in the refrigerator and just cool it. I don't think you want to do that. Comes slowly. Okay. I got a log off. You just swirl this around and you're going to pour it over the chicken. And that's how you serve it. Lemon chicken. I gotta put some foil on it because we got more to do. So, I hope you try it. Take care. Let me see how they do this.